and Clemmer. It is Tuesday. It's 2 o'clock on the West Coast. Some call it the best coast. It's not for me to say. Hey, we're going to play with the stamp set that you might have missed out of the Stampin Up catalog. And maybe if you haven't, we'll come up with an idea together. Once again, hey, Ann Clemmer, Domino, StamperDog.com. Let's get started. Stamper come. Domino! Hey, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. We're going to have some of that Texas weather today. Yeah, I don't know how fast it's going to be, how hot it's going to be, but it's going to be hotter than it's been. It's been beautiful here. You know, the weather is changing all the time, and I see some of my friends are here from North Carolina, Texas, and Wheaton, Illinois. Okay, so here, Marcy's up with the first temp check-in. 106 feels like 113. Yeah. I can still remember when we moved here from England. And, you know, England and my hometown of Tacoma, Washington, very similar weather, at least it used to be. Oh, yeah, hold on. Let me get the right glasses on. Anyway, so we moved here. It was 107 degrees, and the dog we had did not want to get out of the hotel room. He would sit there underneath the chair that was with the table, and they'd go, yeah, I'll be here when you get back. Poor dog, yeah. And I didn't realize then what I know now, and not totally. You know, when you're taking your dog out for a walk, put your hand down on the pavement, and if it feels hot to you, honey, it is hot to them. It's very hot to them. So don't burn their pads. It's not pretty. Now, I've never done that to a dog, but I don't want you to either. So I know that we've got, oh, some of you over there on YouTube, you're really quiet so far, but we can't wait to talk to you. So let's get started. You know, I told Susan I was going to show you this. But, well, maybe even before I show you this, I'll show you that. Hold on one second. This, yeah, coming up on Thursday, July 13th, right? After all the fireworks are gone, hopefully. We're going to be doing our Stamp and Play Day. And we make a card together. Now, I'm going to show you that card in a minute. And then we go and then we play a few games, and I give away all of the class fees. I mean, come on, you can't beat that. And I will show you, this is the card that we made last. Well, this was the prototype, right? Oh my goodness. See, oh, okay, with Texas, they're all having a contest down there. Now, Kay says it's only 99 like in Houston, and they don't have the humidity that we don't. At least that's my story. But this is the original one that I made. This is one of the online exclusives that you can get. It comes with a leaf set that is now back in stock. Yay! And I wanted that to look kind of like either white wine or beer, whatever, right? And then this is the one I made along with them. So even though you don't know what we're going to make in advance, you get an idea of what to have on hand, and then we all make it together. So it's not really like a mystery card, but I showed them how they could turn it into a gift card holder. See there. You know my theory to a great card, put a $50 bill in it, everybody will like it, right? So there you go. Oh, golly. Okay, so we now have our official report from YouTube. New Jersey is in the house. She's feeding the cats. Oh, golly. Yeah. That's why the dog doesn't need tail four. Okay. So Susan is a regular player on these times, and she brought her 9-year-old granddaughter, Gracie, and because you know she's a new crafter to me, I went and sent Gracie a kit, and look at what she sent to me. Now, I'm not going to show you what she said on the inside, right? But it's something a 9-year-old would say, and she really liked, she liked, you know, crafting with her Nona. Yeah. So anyway, isn't that a beautiful card that she made me? I'm like, yay, cool. Yeah. So it's really important that we share crafting with our younger generation, you know, because, you know, I don't know about you, but for me, my mom and I didn't craft. Nope. However, she did buy me craft things to do. I can remember, okay, I might be dating myself, but and somewhere I've seen this. It was a kit and it came with two pictures about this big, right? And then you would use glue and glue down little colored stones where they told you to and little strips of like our twine, only like metallic, right? Yeah, the metallic trim that we get and stuff like that. And she hung them up in the front room because they did look good. Those are like, and she sent me to oil painting lessons one summer. Of course, I took ballet. Yeah. I'm so graceful. How about you? Did you take ballet? Did you take baton? My highlight of my baton career, I went and took 3 cartwheels across the front of the stage. And on the third one, I landed on my caboose. So yeah, that was when I really didn't want to do it anymore, I'm sure. Okay, so here, yeah, so anyway, she made sure that I had my crafty side worked with because my mom believed in, you know, learning things. I mean, I went to summer school. You might not like this, but to me, it was normal, right? I went to summer school every summer from 4th until 11th grade. I think it was 11th grade. Yeah. Fourth grade, I learned how to type. So by the time I was a senior and I just went, oh, my friend's taking typing and I'm going home at 1 o'clock because I have so many extra credits. So maybe I'll stay in the thing with her. And so what happens when we first start typing and they're doing those little 1 minute timed writes? You know, I didn't know how fast I typed, but they were all going F, 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 space, or whatever they're doing. And I was going, yeah, we wouldn't make it in today's world. Okay, so Beverly did hooked rugs. Did you ever do that? I can remember doing those braids with my aunt where you braided rugs and then you sewed them together. I think I did a hooked rug one time, but that was after I had left home. So that was later. Yeah, I'm so glad I took typing at a young age. And now, you know, everybody needs to know typing and get their thumbs worked out. Okay, so Kay said that she embroidered. My mother embroidered, and I have a beautiful picture that she put at the fair, and that's in the front room. Maybe I'll send it. I'll post it in the dog pound. And then, see, Yvonne and Susan did latch hook rugs. Let's see. Okay, yeah, my grandmother gave me her, she wanted to buy me a new sewing machine, but she gave me her sewing machine. I took, you know, home ec in the summer sometimes. You know, it was just something to do because for my mom, she felt like it was a good babysitter because she was working full time. So what's she going to do? Just let me just sit and veg for 3 months? Well, you know, if that's what you did, that's cool. But my mom just, that's how she was wired. And so that's what we did. Oh, Yvonne, I won't tell that publicly. Okay. I only liked it because that first day when I came in and I just smoked them, you know, and I wasn't probably even typing maybe 30 words a minute. I'm sure I wasn't, but they were all real beginners, you know, and I just came up, you know, I was just doing it for something to do. See, now this is cool. My mom made sure I learned how to sew, but yeah, it skips a generation. My grandmother used to sew. And my friend Cindy, she does crafts with her grandkids. And plus she does stuff for the church and she has the grandkids help. So she's not just doing it for her. She's not just doing it for them. She's doing it for the greater community. And, you know, gotta love that. And if I missed anybody... Yeah, see, this is what Susan says about Gracie. Yeah, she's her crafting buddy, but they just don't live nearby. You know, and so, but she did tell me that Gracie likes paper crafting, and you can tell it. You know, something just told me that I should send her a kit, and I did. And so, you know, I highly recommend that. So anyway, so let's get to today's thing. You know, I, Oh, good thing I didn't have the camera on, but I'll show you anyway. You know, this is the stamp set that I got to stamp with this weekend. Stampin Up had something that was just for demonstrators. Hold on. Anyway, it was just for demonstrators. Now, it wasn't free, but it wasn't, it was like $35, right? Like what you would pay for a class with me, maybe, right? And then that did not include anything except for, you know, you got to come to the thing, and it was like, hold on, 10, 4 hours long, something like that. But they gave you breaks and they showed us stuff. Well, this is the stuff that we did. Hold on, do I have the... I've moved stuff around because I wanted to make sure I had Gracie's card. Well, I put it down, but you can, I did post it because I do have a picture somewhere. Hold on 1 second. You didn't have to buy the stamp set. You could, oh yeah, I got to find where I put that. I know I put it somewhere special. Which, by the way, and see, look at, so all that was, I don't know, $54, I think, something like that. And hold on, let me go and see if I can find that picture real quick. It shouldn't take long. Well, that would be nice if these... That's interesting. That's very interesting. It's not updating with the newest things that I have. I don't know why. Okay, so much for that. I just love when things happen that I wish didn't happen. But anyway, yeah, maybe I'll come across it, but it's not here. It's not here right now. And I know I had it. So anyway, we got to do it. And if you would have been on my team, you would have been able to stamp along with me. So yeah, it was such a great thing. And they showed us some, we had projects we could do with them. And then we had projects that we could just watch them do. And I learned a lot. Good question. I think it's going to be the 5th of July. I think it's going to be the 5th of July. That's the one thing that I never did look up is when you can get it. But if you were on my team, you could get it now. Yeah, you could get it now. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And right now, oh, not that, not that, this one. No, not that one either. But I might as well tell you about it. We got a paper sale that's ending Friday. That's 15% off. There's 13 packs you can pick from. Most of them are like $10.60 or something like that instead of $12.50. And one of them is more because it's a double pack. But this is the one that you want to be aware of. And ending Friday is the starter kit. Right now, you know, you can always buy it for $99, and you usually get $125 worth of product that you get to choose. But just through Friday, you can get $155. Yeah, Deb, I don't know that right now. I'd have to look that up. And you could find that too. Well, maybe, I'm not sure. Anyway, so there. Yeah, it ends Friday, the starter kit. And so why not do that? The next time you can come to one of these online things with me. Ha, yeah, Patty, yeah. And I hope you used your coupon, yep. Yeah, she said she scored big time with the discounted designer series paper. Yeah, I mean, what's not to like? There's, you know, 13 to pick from, oh my goodness. So back to this. Let's get back to this. Got things stacked in two different spots because I did this card, right? I did this card with this set, and this set is on page, look at, there's, That's on page 115 in the catalog. There you go. I knew it was here somewhere. And that's how Anne loses dies and stamps. Yep. They stick to something else. Yeah. Good thing you don't hang out with me for perfection, because it's just not in the cards. So anyway, I made this card because we had a young guy that he went through ministry school, right? And to become a missionary. And I think he's going to be in the right profession. And I'll show you the card, because I made it and I gave it to him. And there is the card. Sorry, it's not bigger, but there you go. Very easy card. He was amazed that somebody went and made a card for him. He knew that I did rubber stamps. He just did not know that I, you know, I mean, that I made cards. Is that funny or what? And there he is. There we are together. Whoops. There we are together and that was Sunday. He's going to be leaving probably this coming Sunday or, you know, shortly after. He is going to Armenia, and he's already been to Ukraine before the war started. So I'm just really amazed at, you know, where he's been able to go in his life. So we're going to start with this softly sketched, and I've got a card in my head, and maybe you can help me with it, because this is what I want to do. And I'll just tell you now, I want to do a kind of spotlight card, and I cut this out, but it's a different kind of spotlight card. And I cut this out 2.5 this way by 3. I'm pretty sure it's 3. Let me double check, because I wasn't going to make it that size, and then I did. And I love it when I've already done this. Now, I'm going to tell you the kind of spotlight I was thinking. I was going to stamp it in saddle brown, that is, because I didn't want to do black and white, but my inks and my papers thought this is saddle brown onto watercolor paper. And that was okay, but that was the first press, and you see, you know, I mean, if it wasn't, you'd have to take alcohol, because it's stays on. And color that in. And so I thought, well, this would be the spotlight card that I would, and I would color it in. Okay, but when I tried to get a color that matched it, well, now this doesn't look too far off, and this is Pebbled Path. This is Pebbled Path. This is, no, this is Pecan Pie. This is Pecan Pie. This is Copper. And this is Copper Clay and Wild Wheat. So you could see those would work together on a card, but they don't quite match this. But this kind of looks like it could match now. I'm wondering if I should do that. But thinking. No, I'm already cut out for this white now. So, okay. We'll do it this way. Now, and I thought, well, let me just test it. Nope, that's not going to work either. Okay. You know, it's one of those things. Okay, this goes with that, and that goes with the other, but that doesn't go with the first one. So, yeah, you know how it is. But I was thinking I would cut it, do this pebbled path here. And I'm purposely going to do it about there. That's where I want it. Okay. See, and Mary, thank you. I'm not the only one that missed it in the catalog. Okay. Look at, see, because that almost looks black, doesn't it? That almost looks black. And that's where I want it. I'm in the midst of cleaning my room. Of course, I've said that before, but now I really have to because somebody's going to come over here the end of August, and it's just too frightful right now. That's all I'm going to say. And like right now, I'd like to know where are my stitched rectangles? So this next one, I'm going to do a memento because I'm going to color it with blends. See, and look at that. That almost looks black. Almost. But I'm not going to do it on this because, see, that's too, I don't know. That looks almost white, but too bad. Let me get a scrap of white that I left over here. I know what's in my head, but I'm going to need your guidance for parts of it. I don't know that I did it as high up as I would like. Now, I washed it in between. Some people don't, but when I'm mixing different inks like the Classic and Memento and stuff like that. See, look at it. Didn't pick that up real good. And see, look at it, it's more, I think it's because this is really juicy, but that's okay. This is Pebbled Path. There you go. And if you don't do this, make sure you do. Before you use this, right, and I've already sprayed it, stamp it on a scratch piece for a minute before you wash and dry, right? And that will keep this so that your husband doesn't have to wash it as often, okay? You should be so lucky to have your husband do it, because I know I am. Okay, so here's my idea. I think this, I only brought one color out here, so let me put the dark over here. And I didn't go with my favorite, which would be, is this dark? It just looked, yeah, dark. Real red or cherry cobbler. I did not do that. Nope, did not do that. I don't know that you're going to tell the difference. I'm not going to color at all because I'm just not. Yes, I have to tell you that the, okay, now, the reason I picked Sweet Sorbet is because it's brighter than, Real Red. And this guy is so dark. Okay, what color should we put in here? Okay, a little bit. Because we don't want to be here forever, but we do want a little bit of different colors. Should we put in... Yes. Tahitian Tide? Yeah, I understand. And we'll work with the light ones only because I don't necessarily want to do a lot. Just just a couple colors. Well, just in case this shows up, I don't think it will. Let's do the light one there. Okay. So let me get a couple of these together here. And you can see this is what I want to get. So am I going to get that with that? Yes, I am. Oh, and I will get a little bit of that. So, There's a lot of that's in there, isn't there? Wait, I don't get a lot of difference in those two, the light and the dark. Now, the problem with this is I don't know where the next size up is. So let me see about, see, that's gonna be too big. Let's see if this will do it. That'll do it. That'll do just fine. Right about there. Yeah, right about there. So let me zip over and cut this out real quick. So see, I cut a whole lot more. Now, if you can tell me where this one is, I just really appreciate it. I don't think I put it in a special place. I think I know what happened, but that's part of the reason why I'm cleaning my stamp room. I've already found the scoring blade that I thought that I lost. It fell off when I was doing a project with all of you. And then I knew it was there, but I didn't know, you know, I didn't go after it right away. And you know what's dangerous about that is that when you don't go after it right away, then you you can lose it. Okay, so there's this. And let me get a black one here. And you'll see where I'm going with this. And then you can help me figure out which one I'm going to use for the card base. That's what I'm a little bit concerned about. But if you put these two away right away, then you'll be able to... let's see how it matches up here. There you go. Now, if this doesn't work out, well, you know, that's just the way it is, then you'll know not to do it, right? Sometimes you learn what you do, what you want to do. Sometimes you learn what you don't. But anyway, back to putting things away. So let me tell you what I learned when I was cleaning out my room yesterday, or in the wee hours. There was some things that where I got some paper and I didn't put them right away. I put them next to where they go right away. And of course, I have several packs of vellum that, guess what? Now I, is it under your magnet bowl? That's the first place I looked. Oh, Marcy, I believe that means that it's an older die. So that would be a place to think, you know, to start thinking about. I tend to count them before I put them away, and that's, yeah. But see, I have a few here. Like this one, I'm sorry, I don't even know where, I know I have several of the stamps out because I was making something. I don't know where the box is in the whole stamp set. It's retired now. Here's the pocket die. And this, oh, I hope that there's a number on this. Oh, there is not a number on this. Yep. See, look at that's, oh, and I have a pen, and then, well, I know where these go. Yeah. People make mistakes and it's just, but it can get expensive. And that's what I was trying to explain to my husband, that, you know, we just have to be careful about, you know, trying to get things, you know, back in their proper spot. Not his fault. I'm sure it's my fault. It's just that, you know, sometimes he cuts things out for me and he might bring it in and I might not put it away right away. And then it connects to something. And oh, now you see that that's put away right now. In fact, while I'm doing this, why don't I just go and put a greeting on here? These are great greetings. See, this is what we did. I hope you know how much you'll be missed. That's on the inside. Or else you could put how amazing you really are. There's hello. And I have to tell you, when I mounted this the other night, I looked at it like this and I'm going, what is that? What does that go with? It's hello. Yeah. You know, you are not alone. That might be a good one. There you go. And it can just go on there, and we're going to put it on with black because. Yeah, he was great. He washed all my stamps for me, and I appreciate that so much. Now, see, now you know I have that right up underneath here, and I always, or almost always, go in and do a test run. Oh, you can't even see where I'm stamping that. There you go. I put that a little bit too much, but that's okay. Hi, Jeanne. Your stuff is in the mail. There you go. Okay, so let's go and put this on. You can't find your glue dots. Go look someplace where they're supposed to be. Okay, I'm going to put a little glue dot right there. I'm sorry if you see my head. There. I'm putting it right there. And now I should have probably gone a little bit lower on him. Yeah. You'll see where I'm going. I hope I didn't make a left turn. I know I cut this out. There you go. I could have put that on a dimensional. Not going to, because I'm committed now, or should be. And I love it. I know I have a white piece of paper here somewhere. Here. Because, you know, I'm doing black on black, people. You know, it's like, how can you get that on there? Actually, it can't. Yeah, okay. Here we go. Now, I did not do a t-shirt fashion show yet, so here, let me go and step back real quick. It's just to remind you, lots of fun in the 24/7 stampers. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to put it on there, right? And then this. Now remember, if you like it, great. Just tell everybody you helped me with it. If you don't like it, just remember it just came to me in a dream. How can I use this card in a different way? I'm gonna do this. One thing I like about this, you can do it really light and you're not gonna, you know, like press the paper down. I was trying to pick up this. It's a hole in the paper. Yes. Oh, golly. You know, Nancy, I will send you your $5 later. Okay. See, that's a little bit big, isn't it? It's a bit big, but you know what? Done is better than perfect. There you go. In hindsight, I would have cut this down a little bit lower, so this wouldn't pop up so high, but that's okay. That's okay. We're working with it. Now, so this is 2.5 by 3. Boy, it's not even on there straight. Yes, and look, can I even put it on white? You won't tell, will you? So here's my ideas. We can put it on this and have a strip of this down, you know, just a small strip of that. We can put it on this, right? That is bland. We could do a small strip of this, right? And then color it with red. You know, like sponge it with sweet sorbet. But because it says you are not alone, that might. But look at what paper this is. This is some of the paper that's on special right now. It's the zoo one. If you just go to pick up a code. It's always best to pick up a code, right? Because those change. And then when you get to the online store, just search for the word zoo, and there is the paper. Yeah, and the flip. So yeah, see this, you could do it. The only thing is, there is no. See, with this one, it needs this. Actually, you could put that over half. But because it's you are not alone, I am thinking this way. Let's try it. I'm going to cut like 2 inches. There's that little score that I missed. I'm gonna cut like 1.5 because I don't think it's gonna be more than 1.5. If you're not doing this already, please do. Just go and put a little. I put the washi tape up here because I'm covering the metric, and then I put a line on it for 4.25 and 5.5, and then I don't get confused when people aren't looking. So let me get out a new. Well, no, it's almost new. It looks new to me until I put it here. It looks like it's got a color on it. Yeah, it's because of the way that I stamped it. Oh, golly. Sweet sorbet. Here we go. We'll see if we like this. Of course, another idea, now that I've chopped a piece off, where'd I put it? Where'd I put that piece I chopped off? Okay. See, that's the part about doing these blending brushes that you don't want to like accidentally. See, now I'm going to have to really make sure that I put a good adhesive down there. Yeah, you are not done. Yeah. You are not done. Come back and help me with those dishes, right? Yeah, this is. Well, who says a leopard doesn't change his spots? You know, you could just go like this all over it too. You know, I mean, it doesn't have to be exact. That's what I keep telling myself because, you know, my friends, when they go and blend, theirs is also even and mine is never even. So, you know, do what I say and not what I do. See, I'm gonna pop a little bit in the middle there so that it's all purposely uneven. I'm with you. It could make you think you got measles. Yes, Nancy's on my team, Beverly. Karen sometimes is in here. You should be on my team. Yes, you should. There you go. Write that down. Because if you wake up in the middle of the night and go, my wish list is too long, oh my goodness, I need to do that, then you want to make sure you've had that tattooed on the inside of your eyelids so you know exactly where to go. Now let's see if this works better. See, I like this because for one thing, you have all the colors in at least two places. You have the black on the greeting, and you have it on the borders. You have it on the pebble path on the card base. You have it here. You have the sweet sorbet and the flower here, and you have it here. Does that make sense to anybody? It looks like blackheads. Okay. Yeah, you know, if somebody works where they sell makeup and stuff, I want a little bit more here. And see, what I had thought before I threw that piece away, right? I'll put this off the side. We could have done this. We could have done this. See? I can still do that. Now I might not like it. Or, oh golly, that is intense. It would have come out better if I would have yes, my fingers have. Okay, there you go. Now it's look like a nasty sunburn. Yes, that's correct. Oh, yeah, okay. Hold on, folks. Oh, this side is not really clean. Time for a new one. It's got a lot of ink on there, so I don't want to. I kind of like that. That is intense, is right. I like it. Yeah, thank you, Jan. I like it. I like it bolder too. Now that's what's nice about this is I just go in very lightly, go across because it's wet. Could have put black over there too. No. And one of the things, if you look really close at the catalog, see, look at, I just put it down. Where did I put it? There it is. Here, one of the things that they mention, I don't know that I would make it this way, but what they mention is you go to get the charcoal blended look, start by stamping the image in a dark ink like we did because the pebble path came up very dark. Then softly blend with the same ink color around the image using a blending brush. So you could do that. I am not liking this. Hold on. I'm going to, I don't like that it's not even down here. So I'm going to put it on like that. See, this is already lifted, so I don't want to lift twice. This is glue for the glue challenged, and that is me. Missed that. Okay, so maybe put it up a little bit. I'm going to hold it now. Andromeda. What's that? Oh my goodness. Oh. It's called the Andromeda strain. Yes. Yes. Hi, Frenchie. That is so funny because I was working. Oh, golly, I'm going to date myself now. I was working in a, okay, let's pick one of these here. See, I only have the white ones left. I don't want that. That might work. In a movie theater, I was one of the last, you know, those might work with, see, you can see where by not putting things away, I have 10 off this and 1 off this. Yeah. I was working with, as one of the last hostesses and not hostesses, usherettes. And at the end, they wouldn't let you in because it was going, am I thinking of the right movie? Am I thinking of the right movie? I think I am. And I think these black ones, these are the classic matte dots. Number 158146. This is the exact part of my personality coming out. I'm putting one right above this white corner, and then I'm putting the others lined up with that. There you go. Do you like it? Hey, remember my theory, put a $50 bill in it and I'd be fine. Color the embellishment. Well, I could, but I'm not going to. I don't have to. It's black. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, it, you know what? I just wish I might redo this on a banner only so that you can read that better. That's because you have to make sure you have a light touch with this on the alone. And that's okay. Even having white to where it comes out a little bit, it'll tone down some of that red. But I think it's kind of easy and elegant. That's just the way I like. Now remember, you can get this paper. It's just over, it's between $10 and $11. It's 15% off. Between now and Friday, as long as they don't run out. And if you want to join my team, let me tell you, now is the best time to do it because you can include that paper and then that means you get even more because they're going to recognize the sale price on the paper. And so you're going to get $155 worth of product for just $99 plus tax. And when we're talking about the paper, when we're talking about the kit, we're also going to talk about the first Friday in July, because I'm going to be here. So I hope that you take time, you know, you don't like have too much of a hangover after the 4th of July, because I have got so many cool papers where I went and bought them. And plus I will have some packaged up where you get a certain amount of them for $20. And I know I've got that over in the dog's garage sale. Yeah. Yeah. And so, oh, see, look at, we got the Patty seal of approval and Elaine too. Yeah, Elaine, I got your stuff in the mail yesterday, out to you. Yep, Kay likes it. Oh, you guys like it? Oh, golly, makes my day. And I hope I've made yours. Hey, Cecil, can you bring the dog in? Let's see how he acts today so he can at least say goodbye. Yeah. Oh, golly. But I couldn't have done it without you because you did help me. I mean, otherwise we'd be looking at a card on this and no, I just didn't want to do that. You know, let's see how fast he can get in here. It's also a bit of a maze to get through here. Usually it's kind of, it's a clear path about this wide. Well, there's part of it that's only this wide. So, you know, got to suck it up. He's coming. He's coming. The problem is this dog has not learned to come straight to me in here because he loves to get loose on the in the stamp room. Oh, wow. Yes. Yes. Come on, old boy. Oh, yes. He needs a... Oh, yes. Burp. I like it when you burp. Yeah. Make my... No. No. Your friends are over there. Right there. He's so camera shy, you know. He's, yeah. He gets it from his dad. Oh, yeah. Now we know. You know, when you come and visit me, you'll know the best place to pet him is right there. Yes. Ah. Yeah. So anyway, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. You've been a real blessing. You have no idea what a great impact you are on my life. And I hope that I am for you. And remember that thing about joining my team. It's a great time to do it. Hey, this is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun
into
your day. Go make a card and make sure to mail it.